A stochastic indicator is a popular momentum oscillator indicator developed by George Lane in the late 1950s, and it's used to compare a specific closing price of a security to a range of its other prices over a certain period of time. The sensitivity of the oscillator to the market movements is reducible by adjusting that time period. It's used to generate overbought and oversold trading signals utilizing a 0 to 100 range of values. How does the stochastic indicator work? The stochastic indicator analyzes a price range over a specific period of time or price candles. The typical settings for the stochastic are 5 or 14, depending with the broker. This means that the stochastic indicator takes the absolute high and the absolute low of that period, comparing it to the closing price. How does one calculate the stochastic indicator? The formula for the stochastic oscillator is K percentage, which is equals to C minus L14 divided by H14 minus L14 times 100. So the C stands for the most recent closing price. L14 represents the lowest price traded of the 14 previous trading sessions. H14 is the highest price traded during the same 14-day period, and the K percentage is the current value of the stochastic indicator. For example, if the 14-day high is $160, the low is $130, and the current close is $150, then the reading for the current session will be 150 minus 130 divided by 160 minus 130 times 100 or 80, depending with your settings. So, how do you trade using the stochastic indicator? Since the stochastic indicator is a range bound, it is always between 0 and 100. This makes it a good indicator of overbought and oversold conditions. The readings above 80 are considered in the overbought range, and the readings below 20 are considered oversold. The readings can be changed to like 75 and 25, or 30 and 70, depending with the market condition and the volatility of the security that you are trading. However, these are not always a sign of impending reversal. Very strong trends can maintain overbought or oversold conditions for a longer period. Stochastic oscillator chartings consist of two lines: the faster moving average percentage K line and the slower percentage D line, which is a 3-period moving average. Because price is thought to follow momentum, a signal is generated when the faster percentage K line crosses the slower percentage D line while the indicator is on either overbought or oversold area. This indicates a sign of possible trend change, and when you have divergence, it increases the signal strength. The indicator tends to work best in a ranging market than in a strong trending market. We get stochastic buy signal when the K line crosses the D line from below while the market is on oversold area, and we get a sell signal when the K line crosses the D line from above while the market is on overbought area. On the chart below, we can see the market being on a strong uptrend, but when you check on our stochastic indicator, it's forming lower low areas, hence making a positive divergence. The stochastic indicator works better in such a ranging market because we are able to get clear signals, unlike in this strong uptrend market. So, what's the best settings for stochastic indicator? The best settings for stochastic indicator depends on individual trading strategy. The stochastic setting of 14, 3, and 3 works well. The higher the time frame, the better, but usually a 4-hour or daily chart is the preferable one for day traders and swing traders. Since we now understand about the basics of the stochastic indicator, let's go to our stochastic strategy. This strategy involves adding 100 exponential moving average on our chart, which will guide us on taking our trades depending with the market condition, so as to avoid false stochastic indicator signals. We will only take a long position when we get a signal from the indicator on oversold area, and at the same time, when the market is above the 100 exponential moving average. To take a short position, we will wait for the stochastic signal on overbought area, and also when the market is below the 100 exponential moving average. This strategy has a high winning rate, as I have backtested it, works better in day trading and scalping, both in forex, cryptocurrency, and futures. In the pound yen chart below, we see the market is in a healthy uptrend. We have our 100 EMA and the market is above the 100 EMA. So we aim to take long positions when we see the stochastic being oversold while the K line is crossing the D line. The profit should be in a 1-to-3 ratio. When we have the stochastic indicator giving us a sell signal, but the market is above the 100 EMA, we don't take such a trade. So, is RSI or stochastic better? RSI indicator is designed to measure the momentum of price movements. The stochastic indicator works best when the market is trading in consistent ranges. When you compare the two, RSI is more reliable in trending markets, while the stochastic is good in sideways or ranging market. Depending with your trading strategy, you can now choose which one will be better. Using one indicator alone does not give a high winning ratio, unlike when you combine it with other indicators. Watch my next video on the MACD and RSI indicator strategy to learn more. If this video has been helpful, remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe the channel. Till next time, see you.